Hello everyone, welcome back for the computer session once again. And previous period already we have started to learn lesson number 5, and that is introduction to hypertext markup language, in short HTML. Then the points which we are going to cover through these lessons are: what is hypertext markup language, means introduction of HTML, then creating, saving and viewing a web page, then HTML element and their types. The next point, HTML head, title, body and their elements. Then HTML font and base font element. Then applying text style. Then aligning text into center, left and right, the alignment, the arrangement. Paragraph formatting. Then we will learn inserting blank lines and horizontal lines, and inserting comment in HTML program. So all these points we are going to cover. Already we have covered what is hypertext markup language. In that we have learned what is hypertext markup language, as well as history of HTML. Then we covered features and benefits of HTML and what are the tags, as we learn two tags. So let's begin the practical and the second point of the lesson, that is creating and saving HTML web page. So today we are going to do practical. So please pay attention and watch it carefully. So for that we need to start Notepad. As we learn in the basic, we need to use two softwares. One is to create and one is to see the output of the program. So let's begin with the Notepad. Here I'm going to start the Notepad. For that, click on start and go to all programs, and in accessories you will get Notepad. There is another shortcut method, that is just click on start and type note, note. It will show you the option. The first one is Notepad. You can create this HTML program in any text editing software like Notepad, WordPad, Microsoft Word. Okay, but I refer Notepad because it is simple. Okay, you can also use Notepad++, but that you need to download. This Notepad software you will get directly inbuilt in your computer with the Windows operating system. So just click on it. Now, basic structure of HTML, we should understand. The first one is the compulsory tag, that is HTML. How we can understand it is tagged? Because it is covered or surrounded by angular bracket. It is surrounded by angular bracket. The first and the last tag would be HTML. Okay, so I have to start this HTML, and here I'm going to close HTML. So you can understand by these two tags. One is with slash and another is without slash. The first one, if you will see, it is without slash, means it is starting tag. And if you will write slash, if you will type slash with this, then that is end tag. So here HTML starts and it's here HTML gets end. So it's notify the system, that is it is an HTML program, means it is a web page. Okay. Later on, second tag will be head. As we know that HTML program is divided into two parts, that is head part and body part. And head part contain the title and basic things. So here I'm going to write title in this. Here I type title. Now, this is our first program, so I would like to give first pro. Okay, and I'm going to close this title. So end this title with slash title in angular bracket. So here we started the title and here we end also in this on the same line. On the next line, this is a head portion finish. That's why I'm going to close the head tag. Okay, this is the structure of head tag. Head tag contain titles. Now, the major thing is about the body. Here we start the body tag. Whatever you want to display on the page of web page, that you need to do with the help of body. Whatever you want to display on the page, yeah, that you have to do with the body. So here I have started the body, and this I want to create one simple program which is given on page number 103 on your textbook. Here I want to display the line, I am learning HTML. This line would be displayed on the screen on your web page. Now body work over, so I would like to close it. So here the body is closed. So dear students, this is a basic structure of HTML program. It should start with HTML and it should end with slash HTML. Then it covers two sections like head section and the body section. Head section, generally it appears on the title bar with the title, and the body display the whole page content. So maximum thing we are going to work with the body in the next practicals. Now I'm going to save this file. So here I'm going to save file. So click save, and I want to type the name Pro One. Okay, Pro One, first program or first one or Pro One, or you can give your name. Okay, so I have given here Pro One. Now the next part is very important. Without space, you need to give compulsory HTML, the extension HTML. So .html is very, very, very important and compulsory. So after name, you need to type .html, and you know, should know the specific location where this file is getting saved. By default, it gets saved in the documents, but I'm saving on my desktop. So from there, I can get the file once again. So pro.html I have saved. Then now I'm going to click on save button. So here it is saved. Now our program is done. Let's see now how to open it. So I would like to minimize this, and we'll go on the desktop of my screen. So here is a Pro One, but now you can see here .html is not appear. So it won't show .html here, but we need to save with .html. So this Pro One. So simply you have to double click on it. Automatically it will search the default browser in your system. If it is Internet Explorer, so it will open in Internet Explorer. And if it is Chrome, then it will open in the Chrome. So my dear students, look at here. This is the title which we have given first Pro, and the body content it appear on the page. So whatever you will write in the bodies, it will appear on this page. And whatever you will type in the title, it will appear here. So if I want to give my title instead of first Pro, I want to give my title. That changes. So where we can make changes, we need to go to Notepad, and in title tag we have to do changes. My title. After doing the changes, please do not forget to save. Okay, we should save it. Go to file and click save. Also you can use the shortcut key Control S. Now file is saved. Now second time it won't ask because all ask the name, because already we have applied the name. And now go to the browser and just do refresh. Click on this refresh button. Now you can see my title appeared. Now I want, instead of this, I am learning HTML. I want Chowra English Medium School, the school name. So how to get it? Very simple. Go to body, body tag where we have written this. We have to change Chowra School. Done. What is the next step? Yes, you're right. We need to save. And just go, and here on the browser you have to do refresh. Now you can see the Chowra. I hope you understood. So today we have learned through this, now the first practical, the basic structure of HTML, which start with HTML and with HTML. It contain two section, head section and the body section. So head section contain the title, and rest of the web page contain web page details contained by the body tag. I hope so you understood this practical. So now let's go for the next practical. What is the next? So before going to start the next practical, let me make you clear. These all are the container tag. Okay. As we learn, there are two types of tag, container tag and empty tag. So HTML has start as well as end. Okay. Two times we have written. So it has start as well as end, that means it is container tag. Same way head is has start as well as end, that is also a container tag, and title also start as well as end, body. So HTML, head, title, body are the container tags. So next practical we will introduce one empty tag also. So wait and watch. So now we are going to make a second program. In this, we are going to learn two different tags, that is head tag, heading tag, and one more, that is empty tag, br. Let's understand these elements. So first we will go for h1. So if you want to apply any heading in your web page, so that you can use head h1 tag for heading. Okay, some titles. For example, now we can see we will make one text information, and then with the help of that we will create it. So in body we need to rub this before things, the few previous things, and now I'm going to paste the information about Mahendra Singh Dhoni. This is a one paragraph about Mahendra Singh Dhoni. So for this I want to give one heading, okay, on the web page. Okay, so for that I want to give Mahendra Singh Dhoni. This heading I want to give, that's why I'll press enter, and I would like to give here Mahendra Singh Dhoni. Before this I need to type h1, okay, and at the end I need to write slash h1. Got it? And let's save and check. Now this is a paragraph about Mahendra Singh Dhoni, and this is the title for that paragraph. So dear students, you may get confused, so please don't get confused. This is the title for your website, which will appear on the title bar on the top, and actually this is the title which will appear on the web page. This will appear on the web page. This heading will appear on the web page. This will appear on the title bar. So let's save this one and do refresh, so you will understand. Okay, you can see now this title appear here, Mahendra Singh Dhoni, and the rest of the things appear paragraph. So this title we applied with the help of, this heading we applied with the help of h1. So there are six heading available in the HTML. So let's do, you can understand by practically. I copied this, paste 5 and 6. Six headings are available, that you can type the number 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So here I have typed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. While closing also, you need to be aware that you need to close these all with the proper, okay, 5 and 6. So the h1 is the biggest one, h6 is the smallest one. As number will increase, the size will get decreased. So h1 is a big heading and h6 is the small heading. Let's see, go to website and do refresh. So you can see this is h1, so it is quite big. This is h2 and this is h6. So which size you want, according to that number you have to specify. Got it? Now we are going to learn a br tag. So now I am going to check totally the file details that would be appear here on the notepad. Okay, so let me delete everything except h1. We want to keep heading, so I want to keep my friends. Okay, and I want to take my friend's name, different friend names, Virat, Rohit, Dhoni. So I have taken three friends name. Okay, now I would like to save and do refresh. So now my friends and Virat, Rohit, Dhoni. Now you can see the one difference. Here it appear on the same line, but here I have typed in the notepad on separate line. So generally what happens, if though you are typing on the separate line in the notepad, it does not appear on the web page on the separate line. For that you need to break the line, and for that you have to use br. Br stands for break line. Okay, BR stands for break line. So I copied and pasted two times. After Virat, there will be line will break. So Rohit name will appear on the second line. After that, again line will break and Dhoni name will appear on the another line. Let's do refresh and check it. First of all, we need to save this and go and do refresh. Now you can see these names appear on the separate line. So here we have used BR to break the line. Now you can find out one difference between this HTML head, title, body and BR. What is the difference? So if you will observe properly, all the tags which we have learned previously has start as well as end. But BR we didn't end anywhere. Why? Because it is an empty tag. So empty tag where it start, there itself it gets end. So start tag and end tag is similar. So in short, it doesn't have the end tag. Okay. So only once we have to write that tag. So here it is started, line break over. Here another BR and that is break over. So BR is empty tag. One example of empty tag, it is BR. So today we have through this session, we have covered now two different element, two different tags, that is H1 means heading as well as BR. Now we are going to learn a font tag. Okay. So let me make revise a short recap of this. Once again, HTML is the very compulsory tag that you have to type, that only computer will understand. This is an HTML codes or the program. Then head tag display the headings, okay, and body tag contain all the web page details. Got it? So in head tag we are generally writing the title of the website, in body tag rest of the things. H1, there are six headings. H1 is used for to apply the heading like this. So you can use six headings. 1, 2, H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. Okay, this is a container tag. That's why we need to close at the end where the title gets or the heading gets in. BR tag is an empty tag which is used to break the line. I hope you understood this one. So, dear students, the next tag is very interesting tag till now. You have just seen your website like the black and white on. So next tag will help you to make colorful your site, website or web page with the help of font tag. So in this we are going to cover font and base font. Two different tags we are going to cover, fonts and base fonts. Now one very simple difference is font tag you can utilize for each and every line. The other hand, base font is used only once in the web page to apply the effect to the whole website. Okay, to apply the effect to whole web page, you need to use base font, and to individual lines you can use fonts. So both are similar, only just you have to change the name, but use you have to keep it in mind, their uses are different. So let's understand the font tag. Let me erase this one. Yeah, I'm going to erase everything. Body I want to keep free. In body now I want to type school name. Let's type Chowra English Medium School. Okay, here I have typed Chowra English Medium School, school name. And now we are going to see how it appears. Okay, so let's save this and do refresh. Now this appear as a black and white. Now we are going to use the font tag. So for that we need to type here. Okay. So where we can type this font tag and how can we type this font tag? So for that you need to write font over here in angular bracket font. Okay, now size I want to increase, that's why I'm going font size. let me close angle bracket here and then we will complete. Okay, so size is equal to, in inverted comma, we can give size like 1 to 6. Okay, so I'll give 6. Finish over here. Now color, I would like to apply the color. Please don't write this size in inverted comma. Okay, directly you can write. Then only just specify, give the space, and then you write here color. Here make it sure the color spelling color. Generally we are writing color, but in HTML please follow this. This is a tag and this is compulsory. You have to write the spelling of color is color. This color I want red, which you have to write in double inverted comma. Sometimes students are making mistake over here. They are typing single inverted comma 2 times. So please use the shift key to type double inverted comma. It is appear just next to the enter button. Okay, this key is available next to the enter button. So in inverted comma, double inverted comma, you have to type. Now we have used font size and color, two things. Okay, now I'm going to save this file and let's check. So font size 6 appear here and color also red. Now for example, if I want green color, so need just, I have to make changes over here. Green and save. And do refresh. Color is changed. Now what I want to do is I want to apply separate color for Chaura and separate color for English, for medium and school, for individual, and their size also I want set different. So we need to type before and after each of these. We have to copy. After Chaura we have to close the first font. Okay, because we want only green color to name of Chaura school. And then this we want another one, so I just type green instead of green, red, then English. After English we will close the font. Then medium we want different color, that's why I paste same thing, font color and this, and this we want to keep orange, orange. And okay, medium school we will keep the same color, 3 colors, and we will check after closing font. So here my dear students, for whatever word if you want to apply the color, you can utilize before that this tag. Where you want to end those settings and those of color and size and everything, there you have to write font slash font. Save this and do a refresh. You can see the multicolor appear now, green, red, and orange. Green, red, and orange. So these all colors, you can utilize more than 12 colors, 12 to 14 colors. That list of colors are given in your textbook on page number 107. So refer the page number 107 and practice this practical. With that, color codes also are given. Okay. So instead of this red color, if you you can apply without name, you can apply the colors also. Like, let me delete everything. So we will keep this only one, so you won't get confused. I have deleted all this. Okay, and fine. Now I want to, instead of this name, I want to give the color code. So color code of yellow is hash. Color code of yellow is hash 1, 2, 3, 4 times F and 0, 0, and just close the inverted comma, save and do refresh. It appeared yellow color, but now I didn't type here the yellow color name. These are the color code, okay, ASCII codes. So you can utilize otherwise this codes or name. So but for you it is easy to type the name. Got it? Save and refresh. So I hope so you understood the font, how we can apply the font size, font color, font face. One thing is remain here, font face. Now this appear with the different style, so we will check it. Okay, that we can use with the help of go to Microsoft Word, and you can check here in the Microsoft Word different fonts are there. So this brush script empty, this font name is brush script empty. So I clicked here and I copy. This is the shortcut where I'm showing you, so you can utilize this. Okay, this way, copy and paste. Otherwise you have to read the name from here. This is brush script empty, chiller, this small name chiller also you can apply. These are the name of the fonts, so you can utilize in with the face. Okay, this is a brush script empty which we applied here. So let's see now how it appears. Go to save and do refresh. Now it appear with the brush script empty. So we'll give red because red color is quite dark. I used a shortcut key to save the file, Control S, and I did refresh. So now it is appear with the red color, right? And with the cursive type. So you can use chiller also. Another name of font is, these are the name of font, chiller. Okay, and save, do refresh. Now this appear with the different. So as you want to decorate your site, you can utilize the different fonts, different style with the help of font face. But for that, you need to know the name of the fonts, which you can get through the Word, Microsoft Word. You need to start and you can see which type of you font you want. Which one, for example, I want this one. So I clicked here and need to select it. Use shortcut key Control C to copy it and paste it into Notepad after font face into inverted comma. So we have done here, save this one and do a refresh. I hope you understood what we have done till now. It's easy and simple. So let's understand the font base fonts. Okay, so same way, just you need to write only over there, instead of font you have to write base font. What we have done now, font. So here you have to write simply just base font. So just you have to write here the tag base font. Okay, and rest of the things will be same. Save file and do refresh.